Hey, welcome to AntLab Games. I'm Anthony.
And I'm Francis.
Today we're going to play
Tesla versus Edison.
Powering Up.
Yes. So this is the long-awaited expansion for Tesla versus Edison. We played the original game. We didn't film it. We're kind of waiting for this to come out.
Yeah.
And this expansion just makes this game dynamite. We liked it the first time we played, and
we'll save that for later. So.
Okay.
What kind of game is it?
I would consider this kind of like an economy game. Yes. So we're now building headquarters. We are still buying stocks and things like that.
Right. So there's a whole lot of new twists.
A whole lot of new stuff. Plays in about 60 to 90 minutes.
90 minutes. And now it's not a 2 to 5 player game. Mm-hmm. It's a
1 to 6 player game.
1 to 6. So yes. We'll explain why when we get to the table. So let's go check it out.
All right.
Okay, welcome to the table.
The big table.
The big table. So this is quite a spread. And mind you, this is actually enough components to play a 4-player game because mm-hmm. we are, in fact, going to play a 4-player game.
Yes.
So what we have here, and I'll briefly go over the setup because we're not going to go too much into what's happened. Mm-hmm. So we've set up Tesla versus Edison with the Powering Up expansion. Mm-hmm. With the expansion comes AI. So AI has been introduced to the game. So we've added 2 AI opponents, and they can be any of the inventors, which mm-hmm. is fantastic. And we actually have 2 completely different AI decks. So we have tons and tons of replayability yep. in the box. So that said, we have Walker. So we've brought in Madam CJ Walker and Elihu. Is that how you say his name?
Elihu.
Or Elihu. Yep. Elihu Thompson. Will be our opponents. So we've got their AI decks up in that upper left-hand corner. So one for Walker, one for Thompson. Francis chose Maxim, mm-hmm. Sir Maxim, and I've chosen Charles F. Brush as yes. my inventor. So we've gone ahead, and so in this game, you actually draft which inventor you want, so we've already gotten past that. And we've already done the first stage of drafting the luminaries.
Yep.
Yes, your luminaries. So your assistants, really. So we've done that. And in this game, you pay $2,000. You start your bidding at $2,000. So she bid first, took Fanny Farmer for $2,000. I did not counterbid. I let her have her. And then I picked up Ada Lovelace. And we randomly discarded 2 mm-hmm. as if the AI was drafting. Mm-hmm. So there's certain things AI does and certain things AI doesn't do. One thing they don't do is they don't use luminaries. Mm-hmm. And they don't have their own money.
Right.
But they will go up in the stock market. They will upgrade and research technologies. They will move the fame track around.
And they will claim patents and things.
Claim patents, absolutely. Money, so. And they will buy stock.
Yes.
It's crazy, crazy talk. They don't sell stock. They only buy stock.
Yes. Though.
So with that said, we've got the board set up. We have the fame track, so that's the player order, and in this game, the AI always goes first, so that both AIs will take their turn in the order that they are on the fame track, regardless mm-hmm. of where we are,
yep.
and then the players take their turn in the turn order. So everybody starts out at the lowest stock level, so all of our shares are worth $12 each. Mm-hmm. The fame track's neutral. We're all level 1
yep.
technology. So
all right,
I think we're good.
It.
So with a 4-player, we can actually go out to Indianapolis.
Yeah.
We don't get to go any further west than that. So we have pretty good sized board to play on. But that's it. The quick intro. We have 14,000 minus 2, so about $12,000
yeah.
each to start the game. And 1 share of our own personal company stock. So another thing to note in this game, we have these player boards, which were not in the original. So you put your luminaries up top. And on the bottom, you have your headquarters, and you can use luminaries to research those, and we'll show that
yeah.
as we go. And the AI will do that as well. So
yeah.
With that, I think we'll jump into the AI turns and see how that plays. Okay, so,
all right.
But before we jump into the AI, we're going to put out propaganda, so.
Absolutely, and we'll flip our event card, and we'll put our propaganda out. So this is kind of the beginning of the turn.
Well, let's put the propaganda out
okay.
first, right?
Yeah.
And then we'll flip the event.
So
that, cause
this is going to be every phase.
Right, because they can take propaganda actions, too.
Yeah. So, did you want to explain a little bit about these?
Sure, players? So these are no different from the first, the original base game, is that these 5 propaganda cards, can be taken as actions, and each of them has a different type of bonus. So Franklin Leonard Pope, if we use a propaganda action on him, he could let us move the fame, move our piece up or down the fame track, two spaces, plus get 4,000. Mm-hmm. Other cards like Dr. Frederick Peterson could let us move up and down the AC/DC track and take 4 grand. Or you could play a propaganda action if there's no cards available, mm-hmm. and just move based on your inventor or luminary's propaganda ability. So that also adds as a bonus to the moves as well. So
yeah,
that's it.
Okay. All right. Great. So the next thing we need to do is reveal our event card.
Event card.
So this is going to be every turn. So we have 6 cards in the pile. There's 6 turns. So,
right.
So we have the Blizzard of 1888 here. So this round, players may not develop HQ cards, which is really unfortunate.
Right. Also, there's a symbol on that card.
Oh yeah, I always forget about that. So this is really important. It's on the lower right hand corner, and on this card we have an X. That indicates that the stock market is not going to move at all.
Right. So why are all these pieces over here? So basically, that symbol will tell us whether or not everybody's stock goes up, down, shifts left or right on mm-hmm. on the stock market track. It is adding event impact to the stock market because there's no longer a stock market action you can take during your turn. So this kind of, you know, breathes a little life into the market, which is pretty cool.
Yeah.
Those events are going to be active throughout the entire turn, and a new event will show up every turn. So,
yeah.
But in this case, this is going to prevent us from building any actions. However, the AI ignores any of those mm-hmm. effects from an event, so they will still get to build their headquarters.
Yeah. All right. Cool. So we'll start with Walker. So I'll turn her card over and I'll kind of show you what this looks like.
There we go.
So this will basically tell us what the AI is going to do in each of these like realms. So this is going to be the propaganda action. So she has no propaganda actions this time. This will be her technology that she's moving up or down, which she's exploring. This will be projects that they're going to take over on the map, and then this will be developing their headquarters, this little flag. Here at the bottom, there's a stock symbol, and that we'll get to that once we do bookkeeping, because it's the only time that we're going to be doing
any
kind of stock action.
All of these now, except for the bottom, which they'll do, take place during the bookkeeping.
Yeah. So she's going to, for her two moves, she's going to develop AC2.
Okay.
And she is going to take the patent.
So AC2. And take the patent.
Yep, that little dollar sign. And she's also going to take AC3.
AC3, so she's
pushed. And she's taking the patent for that.
Push the AC system up 2 notches. That's her action, really, for the turn.
All right, and for Thompson?
For Thompson.
He is developing bulb technology to 2.
So he's going to move up to 2.
And he's taking the patent for that.
Taking the patent, so there.
And he's also going to develop his laboratory.
Okay.
So like Anthony said, this is the beauty of AI. They get to ignore pretty much everything. So.
And he has a stock action as well that he can take later. So the headquarters cards all have different passive or one-time events. So you just have to read the text and tells you what happens. So if Thompson were a human player, it would get +1 lightning bolt when the company takes a technology action. So it's bonuses like that. So, and they also are worth victory points at the end of the game, depending mm-hmm. on how many of you've had built. So, that's it. Yep. AI is done for now.
Okay. So it's my turn, right?
Now, so the AI, always goes first, regardless mm-hmm. of where they are in here, except for relative to each other. That's why Walker went first and Thompson went second. Mm-hmm. But now the players get to go, and they go in order of their pieces in the track, in the current track, present.
All right. So I'm going to use my Fanny Farmer card, and she has all the cards have kind of values along the side. So I'm going to go ahead and develop DC technology, and for that I need 1 lightning bolt and 1 gear. It tells you right on the board what you need to do that, and she has that and then more. So I'm going to go ahead and develop that, and because she also has a dollar, I can also afford to do. Oh yeah, thanks. I can also afford to do the patent, so I'm going to do that.
Okay.
Perfect. So that's it. And then I'm going to exhaust her by turning her over like that.
Okay. Let's go over real quick.
So our
inventors each have now a passive ability, you know, that is unique to them. So for Charles Brush, he's entrepreneurial, so he receives an additional $1,000 discount per phase when he personally claims a project.
Okay. Did you want me to get over Maxim?
Of course.
So he's so worldly.
Yes.
He pays only half the regional reputation penalty when he personally claims a project. So that's probably not going to come up on probably till next phase, but I'll explain that when and if it happens.
He does travel the world once a year.
He is going to travel the world.
Once a year. In December. Okay, so... what I'm going to do is I'm going to take advantage of Charles Brush's abilities right away, and I'm going to get an additional $1,000 discount per phase when he personally claims a project. So he's going to claim a project, and I'm going to choose for my first project to build in Albany. So I'm going to bring power there. So that's a level one project, and it's got one of these smaller homes. So the cost is $4,000, and the stock uptick is $4,000. However, he gets $1,000 off of that, so that's $3,000, and he also gets any money on him gets multiplied by the phase, and that can adds to additional discount because he's funding it. So since we're in phase one, he gets $1 off. So $2 off the project, and I owe $2,000 instead of $4,000.
To the bank.
To the bank, and I go up, because I'm not using anybody's patented technology. Mm-hmm. This is level one. We're all level one, so I can build that. But I'm going to go up four ticks on the stock market.
Okay,
so
and you're
I am the turquoise.
One.
Or teal.
Two, three, four.
So my stock is now worth $16 a share.
Very nice.
All right, your turn.
Okay. All right. And I think I'm going to go ahead and use Maxim, and he'll do some inventing too, I guess. I'm going to use him to increase my bulb technology to level two.
Level
two. So in this game, if I want to build a project on the board and I want to use level two or level three or level four, whatever, I need to have explored this technology in both either AC or DC and the bulb technology.
Mm-hmm.
So moving up on just one track isn't going to be enough. So I'm going to use him to upgrade my bulb technology. Since, Thompson already has the patent.
Mm-hmm.
I can't claim the patent, but at least I have the technology. So that's all.
All right, I think for my second action, I'm going to use Linda Lovelace, or Ada Lovelace. Who's Linda Lovelace?
Who's Linda?
I don't know. And I'm going to go up. So I need two power and one gear to go up to bulb level two. And that will bring me there.
Okay.
So that's it. That's the end of our action. So after the action phase, we go into bookkeeping.
Okay, let's
and
do it.
The game also comes with these nice handy-dandy reference cards.
They're so nice.
They tell you exactly what you need to do. So let's go ahead. So first thing, I'll just read down the card.
Okay.
It's easy to keep track that way. So first thing you can do is adjust the fame track. So the highest player gets a stock gain equal to the phase. We're in phase one, so...
So that'll be Walker.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Walker goes up.
And
stock.
We are in one, so...
Excellent. Players with the highest level patent in the leading technology.
Mm-hmm. Now, we don't have a leading technology, so this won't apply.
Okay. Move the AC/DC one space towards the center.
So and
it's already there.
Mm-hmm.
Players take cash equal to the profit listed on the board. Okay.
Okay.
So
you are at $8.
I am at $8. So the profit, depending on which column you are, based on your stock price, that's how much profit you take at the end of the turn. So I get $8,000.
Okay.
Just a fledgling company.
Alright. $8,000. There you go.
Alright, that works.
And I get $4,000. And our AIs don't make any money. So.
They don't collect.
Yep.
They don't need it. Alright, so in the current fame order, first trade one share for another. Okay, so this is where the AI is gonna do their stock actions, right?
Yep.
So
here we have the Walker card back. And she's going to purchase one Walker stock.
One share of Walker stock. It'll tell you exactly what they want to do. So I'll put that in her stock pile.
And stock pile. Okay. And Thompson's going to take one of his own as well.
Of course he is. All right. So now we have an opportunity to
purchase stocks.
Right. And it's kind of different in this. So you can sell a share of stock to buy another one, and you'll pay the difference. Or you can buy a share. That's it.
Mm-hmm.
So you're essentially trading a share or buying a share.
Yes.
None of this selling shares.
None of this
nonsense.
Selling shares to kick people down.
For the sake of just selling shares.
Yeah.
So you're first. You get to choose if you want to buy some stock.
I'll buy some stock. I think I'm going to buy some Thompson stock. So that'll be four. No, that'll be...
We probably should boost them up, yeah. We didn't knock them up. So Walker bought her own stock.
She
did. So she's actually
going
to go up one notch. So when you buy...
That's going to change my...
If somebody buys your stock, it goes up as many dollars as the phase you're in.
Right.
So we're in phase one. So, and then Thompson bought his stock, so his goes up one.
And I changed my mind. I'm actually...
Now you change your
mind. Well, it's hard to do in the beginning.
I know. So what are you going to do? You're not going to buy?
No, I'm not going to buy.
Okay. I am actually going to buy... some of your stock.
Oh.
So okay. Here is...
You believe in Maxim?
$12. I believe in Maxim.
Okay.
I believe it is our future.
Is it because I win every time we play?
No, it's not at all. It's because you cheat. That's why. Okay, so now we go to the... So now that's everything. Everybody's taken their actions. Everybody's bought their stock. Now we can refresh. So we flip all of our luminaries.
Okay.
We discard the event card.
Okay, it's... Consider it discarded.
Consider it discarded. Advance the turn track. So we are in turn two. And then after turns two and four, we'll have to refresh the propaganda. And after turn six, the game's over. So
right now we're
that is it. That is the very first turn. And we are ready to jump into turn two. All right, let's go. First thing, event reveal.
All right, hopefully we can build in headquarters this time.
Let me hold it up here and you can read.
All right, so we have... Groves and O'Lowry. Players must pay $3,000 to the bank in order to file a patent this turn.
Wow.
So good thing you made all that money.
Very good.
And this little directional indicates that everybody's stock is going to move up one.
One notch.
One bump. So
okay.
I will take care of that.
So we have a healthy market.
Three, four. Perfect.
All right. So we have to remember $3,000
for a patent. Okay.
All right, and turn order did not change, so let's go ahead and knock out the
Walker
AI. Yeah.
All right, so really quickly.
So what do we have?
Walker's going to move up DC2, DC3, and take both patents.
Didn't she just do AC last time?
She did.
All right, so she's moving up to DC3, and she's going to take... Well, she can't take
the
first.
She can't take that one.
But she can take the second.
Yep, exactly.
Okay, very good.
Okay.
Wow.
All right, and that's all she's doing.
Wow, okay.
She's kicking that stuff up. And then Thompson... is going to upgrade Bulb to 3 and take the patent for that.
Jeez. Of course, they don't have to pay 3.
They don't have to pay. Yeah, that's
all right, so that's done.
And then, all right, so this is interesting. So he's going to build. And the way that this is signified on the AI card, we have this little directional arrow that's pointing up, and then we have an N for north.
Yep.
So he's
going
to take the northernmost level 1 that's available.
So that's
going to be
Lynn.
Okay.
So he just took Lynn.
Right.
He would pay $4,000 if he had to. But he's going to go up plus 4 stock.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and there's no indicator. So he's going to.
1, 2, 3, 4.
And it would be in his highest technology based on where the track is.
Right.
So they're always going to do the best move, obviously. Mm-hmm. So if it was the DC track was down here, he would obviously try to build it DC if he could, right?
Yeah, exactly.
Or vice versa.
Yep, but right now it's all
right.
Level,
so his stock moved up and he just built his first project. So very good.
Very good.
All right, let's see. You go now.
All right, so I am going to I'm going to use Fanny.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm going to start building my headquarters, I think.
Okay.
And I think I'm going to flip my studio, my studio.
Okay.
So, what's nice about these cards is that you're laying, as you can see, they're laid out kind of under our headquarters, not flipped over or developed yet. But they do tell you what the bonus is, so there's no surprise when you flip it. But when
surprise.
You do flip it, boom, you get the guy. So this is George Washington Ferris, and he's going to allow me to immediately take $5,000 per phase from the bank.
Wow.
So I just get that.
So you get $5,000.
Yeah, and there's some really neat like flavor text at the bottom.
Oh. So if you flip that in phase three, he would give you $15,000.
Yeah, but I get this per phase.
No, it's a one time.
No, it's not.
One time.
One time, it says per phase.
Right, so per phase you're in. What phase are we in?
Phase one.
Right. I think the studios are a one time action, all of them.
Oh, well, that's.
You don't. I'll let you take that back. You take that back.
You take that back.
Looking at all the studios, I'm almost 100% positive they're all one time.
Okay.
Because that'd be way OP.
All right. I'm gonna.
But you could do it now. That's $5,000. That's like money in the bank.
Some money in the bank round.
Yeah.
All right. Well, maybe I won't do that then. Maybe I'll build something. Okay. All right. So I'm going to use Fanny to build something instead.
That sounds lovely. Where would you like to build?
What's she going to build? She's going to build. How's about? I think she'll take. What do I have? She's going to take a level 2. And what do I want to do?
Let's see.
How about
choices?
I have actually choices. Everywhere.
You like to build out in the Midwest.
I do. I like to build in the Midwest. I think I will take Columbus.
I figured that.
Yes.
All right.
And that's a baby project.
It's a little baby project, so it's a 4,000.
So that'll be 4, and she's got a buck, so it'll be 3.
It'll be 3. And obviously, you're building that. That's a level 1 or 2.
That is actually a level 1.
That would be a DC. So yep. Just for the sake of explaining.
Oh, right. So, just for the sake of explaining, that'll be a level 2 DC project.
Right.
I do have to pay patent fees, though, for
you
the bowl.
You do, for the bowl.
Yeah, because I have the DC level 2, but I have to pay the bulb technology. And we don't pay directly to our AIs, we pay to the bank.
Right, and we pay times the technology level, right?
Correct. So, that's going to be $2,000.
$2,000, yeah.
So, I'll pay that to the bank. The bulb,
right.
To do my project, and then I get a 4 stock bump.
You do.
1, 2, 3, 4.
I feel rich, more rich already.
You should. I'm so poor.
Yes. Okay. So I think with Linda Lovelace, I'm going to. Well, we'll use her again. I'm going to do a propagander, and I get to move up 3 spaces. On the propaganda track, and that's because with this card I get 2, and with Lovelace's propaganda meter she gets 1, so that's 3. So I can push myself up 3 notches. So I go 1, 2, 3, and I push everybody else. I'm pushing everybody down, and I push that on the future track, and then we'll move that over on the on the track later.
Yeah,
so
it's a nice way to keep track of
where
what
you
it
were.
Should look like. Yeah,
and she doesn't have any money, so I don't get any money bonus, but I do get $4,000.
Okay.
And that is used.
There you go.
All right. Now you get to go.
Okay. Well, actually, Walker's going to go, right? No.
No, they're
we're
going.
Done.
They're done. You go.
No, we're done.
What? You're not going to use Maxim?
Oh, yeah.
You don't have to. I'll go.
No, stop it. Okay. What do I want Maxim to do? These projects are a little expensive.
I know.
All right, I am gonna do another project, I think. And I think I'll just go for. I'll go for a level 1. In Toledo.
Holy Toledo.
Holy Toledo.
All right.
So he's got $1, so that'll be...
$3,000.
$3,000, and I've got 5, so I'll get 2 back.
Give me one of your cubes, and I'll put it in Toledo. All right, so you've just powered Toledo.
Okay.
Very good. All right.
And I'm going to bump up 4.
4 spaces.
1, 2, 3, 4. Okay.
Just screaming ahead. Okay, so for Charles Brush... I'm going to actually just, I want to research. I do. So maybe what I'll do is I'll research. I have a 2 and a 2, so that'll actually let me research DC. So I pushed him up the DC track 1. I think that's what I want to do. Do I want to do that? Actually, no. I'm not going to do that. Get back there. What did I push up here? Did I push him up? I think I pushed him up instead.
Why are you cheating over there?
No, I don't think he didn't go any DC. I just pushed him up. So, I'm not going to use him to do that. I'm actually going to use him to do the laboratory. and the laboratory is going to give me +2 to either lightning or gear when Brush is personally involved in a technology action. And that's what I'm going to do. So that's it. And we go into the bookkeeping phase. Okay, let's get to bookkeeping.
Okay.
So, just a fame track. Highest player gets stock equal to phase. So we're in phase one.
And I'm going to just adjust the present to match the future. And you are on top.
Okay, so.
You go up one.
I go up one stock.
Okay.
Player with the highest level patent in the lead of technology. So we're flat again.
Mm-hmm.
Move ACDC towards center. Still there. Players take cash equal to profit, so we'll take profits.
Okay, so I am at 14.
Yep, and I am at 12. And 12 now we go into the AI stock phase. So what are they going to do?
All right, so, so Walker is going to purchase the highest stock,
all right,
which
so
is mine.
He's gonna. So Walker is gonna purchase. Well, she is gonna purchase Maxim, and Maxim's gonna go up $1.
Okay. All right. And Thompson is buying more of his own.
Of course he is.
Investing in himself.
He only loves himself, so he should go.
You can go love yourself.
Okay. Would you like to buy some stock? Actually, no. I think I'll ask myself first.
Yeah. Can you ask yourself first?
I should go and ask myself. Yeah. So, I think I'm going to buy some Walker stock.
All right. Walker, Texas Ranger.
I don't know if I want to, though. I'm going to be so broke. I really can't afford it right now.
Okay.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Well, hold out then.
That gives me $7,000 for projects. No, I think I'll have to hold out till next round.
Okay.
Hopefully she stays cheap. Okay, so that's it. Refresh, flip all luminaries.
Okay.
All right. And we discard the event card.
Yep. Consider it discarded.
Okay. Advance the turn track.
Mm-hmm.
And after turn two, refresh propaganda cards and have a luminary auction.
Yes. So these guys go away.
There was very few.
There were very few.
There were very few propaganda actions that round.
Yeah, there really were.
Because normally the AI hits those really hard.
Yeah.
All right. So go ahead and I guess put the new propagandas out.
Oh, wow. Look at that.
Oh, that's... Woeful cries first
Whoever
loses.
Whoever cries first loses.
Oh, wow.
It looks like he's crying.
He is crying.
Is he losing?
He must be.
All right, so there's our propaganda.
Okay.
And we need to do a luminary auction.
We do. Hmm? Okay, so this one's going to be different because now we are shuffling in stock certificates. All right, yeah, let's get that out of the way so we can do the luminary auction. All right, okay. So bring the last two we had. We add them to the new deck, right?
Yes, these get added randomly to our new deck. So we only have, you'll have two sets, like two decks of luminary cards.
Yes.
For the third phase, it'll just be leftovers.
Whatever's
from
remaining.
Everybody. So you want to shuffle these up?
Well, it really doesn't matter. We're turning them all
over. It really
up,
doesn't
right?
matter.
No, so hand me the stock certificates because those I need to shuffle.
Yeah.
And we're going to apply them. So go ahead.
Yeah. So these are two of each of our remaining stocks.
Right, so you put
and
these aside.
Those are going to be assigned to each of these luminaries. So when we bid on the luminaries, we're also going to be paying attention to the stocks that they carry with them.
Right. So they're bringing their personal stock investment portfolios with them to my company. Right? So we're going to say, so she's Maxim.
Okay, I'll just stick that
in. Yeah, he gets Walker. He gets Thompson, Walker, Thompson, Brush, more Brush, and some more Maxim. All right, so now the bidding starts at 4,000 in round
yes,
two.
Yes, it does.
So I get to bid first because I am higher on the track.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, look at this guy. He's only got a $2 bill.
He only has $2.
It's no bueno for me. I'm sorry. He's not going to work for me.
He's literally not going to work for you.
Nope. So what I think, what are we looking at here? We're looking at Walker stock and Mount More Maxim. Yeah, I'm gonna go with Josephine Cochrane for 4,000. That's my bid. You gonna counter it?
No, you can have her.
All right, here's four for the bank. I will take Josephine and one share of Maxim stock.
All right, and I will take I'll go ahead and take Mr. William Stanley Jr.
He will for $4,000.
Yeah, sad though to be looking.
That's okay. What company. Does he come with?
He comes with some Thompson stock.
Oh, that's not a bad gig.
No. All right, so and he'll be $4,000. So one thing that we didn't mention about this is that if you actually can't afford to bid on a luminary, you'll end up just getting one random.
One at random.
And so you have to pay $1,000 for him.
So. We have to pick one for each of them randomly.
Mm-hmm. I'll just do this.
Well, hold on. You just... Because they're assigned to... Because they had stocks assigned to them as well, right? Is this the way they were?
I have no idea.
I don't remember. No, I think he was up here.
Okay.
Who's down here?
Sorry.
That's okay. So yes, we have to pick them at random. So I will flip them over. And we just need to get two at random, right? So I'll do like the shell game. And you can just pick one for Walker. Doesn't matter. Anyone. Right, pick a card, any card. Because what we're gonna do is he's going out of the game, but she's going to get a one share of Maxim.
And I guess that one.
And this one?
Yeah.
All right, and he is going to get one share of Brush. Look at you. All right, so these guys are all now going to go
back
as they were back, and we'll keep them over there. And they'll come back out for the last phase.
Okay, so here's our propaganda again. Ready to go.
All right. So that is it for the refresh.
Mm-hmm.
And now we can jump into the event reveal.
Okay, so event... All right, this is exciting.
All right, so go ahead.
I'm going to hold that up. So we have an auction. So opponents must pay you $2,000 in order to claim a project this turn.
Okay.
Okay.
So, auction cards, we basically will bid each other for the rights to own this card.
Exactly.
And force the other player to pay us an additional $2,000 to claim a project. It also has the left shift on stock prices this round. So I'm going to shift everybody over one entire column on the stock market. So that hit us all pretty hard.
Okay.
All right. So what's the starting bid?
So we're going to follow the same procedure as we do for luminaries.
Okay. So I'm guessing it's 4,000 for the start.
So it'll be 4,000 for the start because we're in phase two.
Okay. So
what are you going to do?
I'm going to bid $4,000 on that.
You are?
Mm-hmm.
And bids are going to go up by how much? 4,000?
No. I don't think so. I think you can just bid another grand if you want. We'll just keep bidding in increments of 1,000.
All right. I will, I'll go to 6.
So you're going to bid 6 for that?
Yep.
You can have it.
Thank you.
So just remember that I have to pay you $2,000 if I claim a project.
Okay, and I'll keep that.
And you hold on to that.
Yep. Over here, so I remember.
Just put it in your assistant's spot.
Sure. All
right, because he looks like he works for you.
Correct.
All right. All right, so that was the event. Now let's go ahead and do the
All right.
The AI. All right, so Walker, right. Texas so Ranger, what is she
going to
do?
Walker is going to
she's going
to
propaganda. All right, so the way this works is basically... she's going to take a propaganda card and get +2 to it.
Mm-hmm.
So she's going to take the best one for the star, and that would be, well, these two are tied, so it doesn't really matter. So she'll take Death of Ulysses S. Grant. So it's going to give her a bump of 2 +2.
Mm-hmm.
So she's going to go up 4. Could you move Madam Walker up 4 on the future track, please?
1, 2, 3, and she can only max out there.
All right, so she is top of the food chain now, and what is she going to do?
And she's also going to take AC for 4.
AC 4?
And DC 4, and she's taking both patents.
So she just went to AC 4 and DC 4?
And she takes both patents.
Oh, wow, so she's just...
She's She's like done.
Monopolizing all the patent industry here. So, all right, she's done, and we go to Mr. Thompson. What is he going to do?
All right, so he's also going to do a propaganda action.
All right, so he'll take this for two, plus two. So bump him up on the old chart, four spaces.
And he's actually going to kick her out of the first spot.
All right.
Like that. So they'll go there.
And he's going to do DC 2.
Mm-hmm.
So bump him up one. He's just going to slide up one. Yep.
Okay.
Because there's no more patents left, apparently.
And
Northernmost 2. So he's going to go to Montreal.
Okay.
And he's going to get a bump, since we're flat, of, that's a small one?
Mm-hmm.
No, it's a medium. He's going to go up $5 on the stock chart.
Yep.
All right, and then he's got a stock action that he'll take later.
All right.
Oh, gosh.
Europe.
Europe. Asia.
That's South America.
South America. All right, so I'm going to use Charles F. Brush. I think, and I'm going to two and a two. Wow, yeah, he could do that. So I'm going to, ooh, wow, I could go, I can get a little crazy here. Where am I? I'm here. So I'm gonna use Charles Brush. Now I get an additional two lightning bolts or two gears when I, personally involved in the technology action, right?
Mm-hmm.
So I want to go up two bumps on the bulb track.
Oh.
So that's going to cost me three lightning and three gears.
Okay. So how are you going to do that?
I can't do that with him, can I? Dang it.
But you have this.
No, it's either or, though.
Yeah.
So I would need one or one.
Or you could use another luminary. You can use two luminaries.
You can?
Yeah.
To do that?
You can exhaust two luminaries in one turn. There's
I don't
no
think
limit.
I want to do that, though. I think that's just silly. I'll use Josephine Cochran to bump my bulb up to three.
Okay.
Because she gets one and one.
All right.
So that's my technology action.
Okay. All done?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I'm going to use Sir Hiram Maxim.
Yes.
And he is going to do a project.
Oh.
He is going to do a project in Buffalo. And here's how that's going to work. So, put that on Buffalo. Buffalo is a level two city.
Right.
So, I'm going to pay patent fees of $2,000 to the bank. Because we don't pay to REIs.
Get that out of the way.
And then, what's happened here is I have skipped a city to get to Buffalo. So what we have to do is we pay a regional penalty, kind of a reputation penalty for skipping over a city. And that penalty is going to be $1,000 times the game phase.
$2,000.
So phase two, so it'll be $2,000. However, Sir Maxim only pays half of the regional reputation penalty when he claims a project. So it'll only be $1,000. So I'm going to go ahead and put...
Well, hold on, let's do the total cost then. So it's going to cost you for a medium-sized project, $8,000 plus one is $9,000
minus
two. Because he's $1 times the phase is $7,000.
Okay.
Right? 8 plus 1 is 9 minus 2 is 7.
Okay.
$7,000 and you go up 5 on the stock ticker.
Okay.
And that was a level 2?
Yes.
Okay. 2 DC.
Yep.
Okay. So I'll move you up five.
Thank you.
One, two, three, four, five.
Perfect. Okay. And then he's done.
Very good.
Okay. You're up.
I will now... Oh, yes. I'm going to need to do some serious... All right, so three, two, and three. Okay, so I'll do that. I'll use Charles Brush, and I'm going to do a bonus. I'll take plus two to my gear. So he's got two lightning and... four gear, right?
Mm-hmm.
So I can bump up two on the DC chart, two lightning and three gears the cost.
Okay.
Right?
Yep.
Done.
Okay. That's your move. You sure don't want to build anything?
Maybe not. my technology is so far behind. I need to do some serious
Yeah.
technological bumpage.
Advances?
Yes.
All right. Well, all right. I'm going to go ahead and use my Fanny Farmer and... I guess I'll go ahead and do some propaganda. So she's got, I don't like turning her over just yet. So I'm going to do this. Whoever cries first loses. And this guy just cracks me up. He's ridiculous. So I get to move AC, DC up or down in whichever direction. And I've got a lot of DC power. So I'll move that up one.
Well, you get to move it again, right?
And I get to move it again because she's got one propaganda.
Right.
So move that there. Okay. And essentially what that means is, you know, if I had taken this move first and then done my other one where I built a project, if you use DC to build your next project, you're going to get a stock bump of +2 in addition to whatever you get there.
That's very nice.
If you use AC, you're going to actually lose one.
Yep.
And then vice versa if you're using AC. So so I get that. And then +7,000, plus she's got a buck, and it's phase 2. So I get 9.
$9,000.
Okay. So I'll take my 9,000.
You will.
And go.
And go. Okay. Take your 9,000 and go.
You're up.
Hold on.
What?
No, you're good. I was just thinking to
myself.
Sure? Yeah, I'm just thinking.
Yeah?
I'm just thinking out loud. Just thinking out loud. Not really. Not really sure what I want to do here, to be honest. To be completely honest. Okay. Because I think I got my I want to build, but I don't. So I'm just going to use Lovelace this round to upgrade one of my... Yeah, I'm going to upgrade my... You know, I don't know. Maybe I'll take propaganda because I want some cash. So I'm going to do Chester Arthur, and I'm going to get to move the DC or AC track, so I'll just pin DC.
Okay.
And I'll take $7,000 because she doesn't get any dollar bonus.
Okay.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
All right. You're up.
All right.
For the final action.
Bring the action. I'm going to... How much would that cost me? Six, probably. I'm going to go ahead and do that. I'm going to use William Stanley.
Mm-hmm.
And he's going to do a project... in Scranton.
William Stan Lee?
Yes.
Alright, so you just skipped another one.
Yeah, so he's going to do a level 2 project in Scranton, but that's this tiny little baby one.
Baby one, yeah.
And he's going to use DC power.
It'll cost you one, so it'll...
Well, hold on a second. It's going to cost me 4. He doesn't have any of this.
Alright.
And then I'm going to have to pay an extra 2 because I skipped a city.
But so you get half of that, right?
No, that's only if Max does it himself.
Wow.
So this is actually going to cost me 6.
6
to do.
Plus 2 more for the patent.
For my patent, you're right.
Okay. $8,000 for that.
I know, it's so expensive.
Wow.
All right, so I'm going to pay that
first.
That's a
6 stock bump.
And then, but yeah, I get 6 stock bump.
What?
I get 6 stock bump.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Woo!
Yeah, that's good, right?
Very good.
All right,
so that's it. Flip him over.
Okay.
And we are now at the bookkeeping. So adjust the fame track.
All right. Ooh, and we have a lot of adjusting.
A lot of movement going on here. So the highest player gets a stock gain equal to the phase.
2.
So Thompson gets 2.
Okay.
Move the AC/DC track 1 space towards the center.
Okay.
Player with the highest level patent in the leading technology gets a stock gain.
Okay.
So who's that? Her?
2, right?
Yeah, she gets it, right?
Yep.
Yeah, she's got all the
technology.
She's
ridiculous.
So players take cash profits now?
Okay, cash profits.
8 to your 20. Wow.
Yeah. All right.
Here's 2. Just give me 10, if you want.
Okay.
All right, you get 20 large, 20 big ones.
So.
All right. And now we can do stock. So let's see what they're going to do. So what is Walker doing?
So Walker, once again, is buying just the most expensive stock, which is going to be mine.
All right.
Of course. And Thompson? Thompson's doing the same thing.
Buying another share of this. Wow.
Yep.
Okay.
Okay.
That's it. So let's refresh. Flip.
Okay, I'm going to discard that event.
All luminaries. Luminaries. Discard the event. Advance the turn track. We are in now turn four.
Okay.
And that's it.
All right.
Okay, so let us start with the event reveal.
Boom.
Santa.
Santa.
Another Santa. Okay.
They're everywhere.
That's Joseph Swan.
All right, Joseph Swan. This is another auction. Take double your normal profits during bookkeeping.
And we go up $2 each on stock.
All right, let me take care of that while you decide if you want that.
So this is going to cost $4,000.
Do you want that?
I'll bid.
Yeah?
$4,000.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I'll bid $6,000.
I'll bid $8,000.
I'll bid $10,000.
I'll bid $12,000.
I'll go $14,000.
You go $14,000?
Mm-hmm.
Hmm. Okay.
Yeah?
You can have it.
Okay. Oh, yeah.
$14,000.
So, I'm giving $20,000, so I'll get... How much did I say I'd give you? $14,000 or $16,000?
$16,000. No, he said $14,000. So, do you take $4,000 back? No, you take $6,000 back.
I'm sorry. Yeah, I was
going to say. You can take all dollars if you want.
No. I want to make it rain. $1,000.
Okay, I'm sure. All right, so let's go with... those guys. So we adjusted the stock prices, and now their actions happen. So round four.
There you go. All
right, just hold it.
So we've got +2 fame cards.
So they'll take...
that's the only one available.
The only one available.
Go ahead and flip it.
And he's going to go up to star +2. So he'll just go up 2. Who is that?
Walker.
So she's going to jump to the top. And what else does she have?
She's going to do bulb 4.
Of course she is.
She's not taking the patent.
She's not.
No, surprisingly.
Wow. So she's going all the way up to 4.
Yeah. And then she's going to take the westernmost level 4.
Wow. So
system.
That would be Louisville.
Mm-hmm.
And that's a mid-sized building. So she's going to go up 5. And she will do it in D.C., of course.
So it's going to be +2.
So she'll go up 7.
Yeah.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Wow.
Okay.
Big move.
Wow. All right. And Thompson is going to go DC3 plus the patent.
Okay. So he'll go...
except there's no patent.
Sorry.
So. And he's going to go up DC4.
And no patent.
And no patent.
So you're late to the game, buddy.
And then he's going to take the northernmost level 3.
So northernmost level 3 is Rochester. Would you agree?
Sure.
More
north than
Detroit.
More north than Detroit.
Detroit Rock City. So that's a middle. He's also going to do, well, it's a level 3, right?
Mm-hmm.
He can't do, he can do DC. I'm sorry, he's level 4.
Yeah.
So he can do DC, level 3.
Mm-hmm.
And he gets, what, 5 plus 2 is 7.
Yeah.
Jeez.
Wow.
He nice. Just bounced ahead of us all. All right, we got some work to do.
Holy moly. Okay.
Okay. So yep. I go first.
Oh, before you do that, so something new about this expansion, with the propaganda cards, they want them always to be available. So once the last one is flipped over, we're actually going to flip everything back face up again for this phase. So no matter where you are in the phase or what turn you're on, you're always going to flip them up after the last card is flipped. So now these are all available for us again.
So no matter where you go.
No matter where you go.
There you are.
What's the matter with you?
I don't know. All right, so I'm going to use Charles Brush right off the bat. He's going to research bulb 4 and throw a patent on it. Yay. My very first patent.
How do you feel?
I feel so good.
Okay.
All right.
All right. My turn?
Yep.
All right, I'm going to use Mr. Williams... do we use William Stanley Jr.?
Oh, Bill.
Bill Stanley Jr.
Yeah, Bill Stanley's pretty good.
I'm going to go ahead and use, I'm going to use him. And he's going to explore my headquarters. He's going to go to the lab.
The ant lab?
So, the ant lab games. He's going to go to the lab, and that allows me to, after I take a technology action, I gain $2,000, I guess, times the phase.
Per phase, that we're in.
Right? Yeah. Per phase.
So, that would be 4,000 in this phase.
Yeah, in this phase, it would be 4,000. So, he's going to do that. So
okay. I am going to work a project. And she's got no money value, so this is going to cost me. But I'm going to go and do New York City level 3 DC.
Okay.
So I need to pay. Well, I don't need to pay the bulb patent because I have a level 4 bulb that I use. Right? As long as you have a patent higher than the project you're doing, you don't have to pay the
correct
patent.
Correct. Yep.
I do have to pay DC 3 though.
Yes.
So we're in phase 2, so I owe her $2,000.
Mm-hmm.
So, if you will. Actually, no, $3,000 because it's a level 3, right?
Yeah.
So, I paid for the patent use of DC System 3, and I now get to build a large. So, it's going to cost me $12,000, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, see, I wish I should have claimed it with him. What a fool. $12,000. Here's
$15,000. Okay.
So, I'm going to get... I'm doing it in DC, so that's
three back.
I'm getting three back. I'm going to go up 8 stock prices.
Okay.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 points in the market. Good jump.
Great.
I'm done.
You're done. All right. Let's see. What do I want to do? What can I afford to do? I want to do another project.
Do.
I do. I'm not level 3 though.
Hmm.
I'm only level 2. It's problematic. We're still in phase 2. So this would be 2, 4. All right, I guess I'll do that. I'm going to go ahead and do a level 2 project.
Mm-hmm.
Or do I want to do... Yeah, I want to do a level 2 project out in Worcester.
Worcestershire? Okay.
Oh, ooh, do I want to do that?
You're skipping
three. I thought it was two.
Three. You're skipping three.
Eek, I can't do that.
That's going to cost you...
That's going to cost me a lot.
$6,000 in just that.
I know.
And it's all a small one, though, so it'll be a $10,000 project. That's not terrible.
It's not horrible. Well, yeah, I guess I'll...
Well, actually, if you do it with him...
Well, I'm going to do it with him.
It'll only cost you three.
Yeah, he's only going to pay half the penalty, right. So that'll only be a $3,000 penalty.
Right.
He does have a buck, and it's phase 2. So this is a $4,000 cost project,
right,
plus the 3 that I have to pay.
7.
So that's 7, and then he gets $2,000 off. So it's only going to cost me 5.
Yeah,
so that's,
do it.
That's not bad at all. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. I'm going to use DC power.
6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Perfect.
You're
and
good.
That was it. So he's done.
Very good.
Okay.
Interesting. What do I want to do? I think what I'll do with Ada Lovelace is I'm going to do another project.
Okay.
And I'm going to go... I want to do... What do? I did a 3 there. I'm going to go and power Boston. That's a level 4 large. So I'm going to do... I can't do Boston, can I? No, I don't have high enough DC. So I can't do that. I can only do up to 3. All right, so I'm going to do Providence. So I'm going to skip a city. That's going to cost me $2,000, right?
Mm-hmm.
So I'll pay the two to skip the city. That is a medium size, so that's an $8,000 cost.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm going to use a patent, a level 3. Is it a 3 or a 2? It's a 2. So I only have to use a level 2 patent.
Yes.
So that's pay you $2,000. Mm-hmm. You change a 5. And the project will cost me 8. So here's 10. That was expensive.
That was a big project.
I know.
For a little project.
But I get 7 ticks.
That's good.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
All right.
All right.
All right. All right. So, what do I need to do? I have some moves I need to make here. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna use Fanny Farmer, and I'm gonna up my DC power. So she's lightning bolt and the little gear, so she's perfect. So
okay.
That is that, and I'm gonna take $2,000 times
so
phase
grand.
Two. So I'm gonna take $4,000.
For doing the technology?
Yep.
Okay.
She loves technology.
She does love technology. So, adjust the fame track. Highest player gets a stock gain of 2.
Okay.
So, yeah, so just
that's going to be Walker.
Walker gets a stock bump of 2.
Okay.
Player with the highest level patent in the leading technology. Who has highest DC?
That's also going to be Walker.
All right. So, she's going to get a stock gain of 2.
Okay.
All right. Move AC/DC 1 space towards the center.
Okay.
Wow, it's diminishing.
Mm-hmm.
Players take cash equal to profits.
Okay. So you're going to get
22?
22K. There you go.
All right.
And I'm going to get 48.
Wow.
Because of my big payoff.
That's crazy.
Which is a swan.
That's a ton of cash.
That's so much cash.
All right. And now we get to trade one share. So
trade or buy, right?
Yeah.
Buy some stocks.
You could trade or you can buy a stock.
Gosh, look at all this money. I need to buy some stocks.
What's Walker gonna do?
Walker is going to buy the lowest stock.
The lowest stock,
which is her own.
Wow. Okay. And what?
And Thompson is also going to buy the lowest stock.
So he's going to buy so. Hers actually goes up 2 because she bought it, and then he's going to buy it.
Yep.
And it's also going to go up 2.
Yeah. All
right. Wow, she caught right up.
Cool. And
I get to see if I want to buy stock now.
Mm-hmm.
And I actually... I'm going to trade.
Okay.
So I'm going to sell Maxim and buy Brush.
Okay.
Sell one Maxim, buy a Brush. So the price difference is what, $5?
Well, yeah, but explain how that works.
All right, so essentially, I have to pay the difference in the two stocks when I trade. So I'm trading in a share of Maxim for a share of Brush. So essentially, I'm selling Maxim and buying Brush. So that's how you sell. So I'm getting $38. Right?
Yep.
So actually, do I gain money in this case? Reduce... Or if you say, yeah, pay or receive the difference. So actually, I receive the difference because this is worth more. So I'm selling a $38 stock and buying a $33 stock.
Okay.
So I'm actually earning $5 from the bank.
Oh, right.
You see what I'm saying?
Yeah. And then you're going to drop his stock down because you're selling something more valuable than what you're buying.
Exactly. So I'm earning $5 for that savvy stock investment, and I'm going to drive my stock up because I bought Brush. $2, bang, bang. But I'm going to push Maxim over a whole row because I sold it.
Right.
So that's how that works.
Perfect.
But that's all I can do.
All right. And I am going to...
Oh, now I can buy any share of my choice. But I'm not, I don't have enough money. I do, but I'm not going to.
Okay. I think I'm gonna buy some stock, I think. Who do I want to buy? Who do I believe in? I I don't think I'm gonna buy some Walker stock.
You are. You believe in Walker.
I believe in Walker. So how much is she? 32.
She's $32. You have a lot of faith.
Crazy. I do.
And you're gonna drive her up to $34, actually.
So that's, there you go, $32.
And there's one share of Walker Enterprises.
Okay.
All right. So flip all luminaries. Discard the event card, which you did.
Mm-hmm.
Advance the turn track. We are in turn 5.
Yep, and this is a new phase, too.
So now we have to refresh the propaganda cards.
Okay.
So these go off the table, but don't do that yet. Let's do the draft first. And now we get to have a luminary draft. So this is the remaining luminaries, right?
Yep. So these are kind of our leftovers.
Yep.
Actually, they're exactly our
leftovers. Enough, right? So we're going to get 2, and then they're going to get 2, and there will be no more luminaries. So that's how the numbers work out. Since I'm first on the track, I get to be, now there's 6,000 a piece.
Yep.
All right, so I will bid 6,000 on Thomas Lawson, I guess.
Don't be too excited about that.
Why? They're not great, none of them.
I guess.
Do you want to rebid?
No, that's fine, you can have him.
Here's 6 large, and I will take Thomas Lawson and a share of Walker Enterprises.
Okay, and I'm going to take Mr. Michael Faraday.
All right.
Mr. Methane. And he cost me 6, right?
$6. Okay. All right, so pick one of T's. Bang, that's going to go to Walker. So she's going to get a share of her own stock.
Okay.
And he gets a share of his stock.
Perfect. That's probably exactly what they would have done.
That's probably the way things have been going.
Okay.
So,
so let's lay out our prop.
That's it. So now we bring out the propaganda cards. And we will get ready to kick off
the final phase. The
final phase, turn 5. All right, let's see what the event is.
Okay. Oh, God. I was just so upset by this card.
Apparently.
Eugene died. Oh, I thought it said
Eugene doesn't die. No, he's dead. All right. Projects cost 3,000 more this turn, and we all move 2 columns to the left.
Really?
Wow. let's see. So this goes 1, 2, and these go 1, 2.
Mm-hmm.
And this goes 1, 2.
Oh my God, that's horrible. Okay.
All right, that's a bad market.
That sucks.
Okay.
All right, well, that's where we're at.
So that's the event. So,
all right, you ready for Walker?
Yeah, let's see what Walker does this round.
All right, so she's going to take a propaganda action.
The best
That'll
one.
Be the best 2 star that you have.
Yep.
She'll
go up 2 plus 2. She's at the top anyway,
yeah,
so.
Yeah, so whatever. Right. And then she's going to take the westernmost.
Yep.
Level 4.
That would be Sinsin.
And I guess
she's going to do 2 of
another
them.
Another level 4. So.
Holy moly. Left. So she's going to do
maybe Baltimore.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wow. All
right. Oh, and she's going to do her headquarters. She's got a gear.
Her headquarters.
Yep.
But we need to bump her stock now. So she went up 2 fours.
Mm-hmm.
In DC.
Yep. Which is +1.
Which is +1.
So, she'll get 10.
She's got, and they're 2 large cities, right?
Mm,
no. Cincinnati was medium.
They're both medium.
Baltimore's big. So she got 5 and 6. It's 11, 12, 13. Right?
Wow.
Does that make sense?
Yeah. Glad about that Walker stock.
Yeah.
Jeez.
How about Thompson?
All right. Thompson is going to go DC +2 down here. So he's taking a propaganda action that involves ACDC.
So 2 plus 2. So he's going to bottom out the DC track.
And he's going to do bulb 4/4.
Bulb 4.
And it already has patent, so he can't take that.
Cannot take my patent.
And he's going to take the northernmost level 4 city.
Ooh, all right. That would
be
Boston.
Boston.
All right.
Boston.
And that would be DC for him.
Mm-hmm.
So he's going to get 2. Boston's a big city, so he's going to get 6, 7, 8 stock bumps. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
They're leaving us in the dust.
They are just screaming. okay, so.
Okay, yeah.
I guess I go first. Ah, oh, that's just terrible. Okay. So I'm going to start by doing a... Oh, this stinks. This really does stink. I guess I'll do... I'll start with a propaganda.
Okay.
All right, so I'm going to use him. He has a dollar value on him. Mm-hmm. So I'm going to take this one and move the ACDC track because it really doesn't matter to me.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, no, I'm going to do this one.
Okay.
This is going to move me up 2 plus 1 is mm-hmm. 3 and give me $8, $9, $10, $11.
Great.
Okay. So I get 11,000 and I get to move the this one up. So I get to take the top seed.
Okay. All right. I'm up.
Yep.
Okay. I'm going to use Michael Faraday, and he's going to develop my studio now that we're in phase three.
Okay.
So I get $15,000.
Yes, you do. All right. $5,000 per phase.
Yep. 15, I said.
Yep.
Okay.
I am now going to play. Do I want to do that? I'm going to play Charles Brush. I don't want to do this, but he's the only one that can afford to do it. Mm-hmm. And bump up to level 4 DC. Mm-hmm. Stinks.
Okay. Alright, done?
Yep.
Alright. They're not gonna go. Okay.
No, so they're done. Yeah, you go.
I keep jumping them. All right. So I'm gonna use Fanny Farmer.
Mm-hmm.
And she is going to develop my office.
Wow, you're doing all your thingies.
Yeah, well.
Yeah. Okay.
And that's gonna give me $1,000 times the phase to trade or purchase stock.
Oh,
when wow. I trade or purchase stock.
So projects cost how much more this turn? $3,000?
Projects cost $3,000 more this turn.
That's so lame.
Yep.
And I kind of would like to do one.
Uh-huh.
I'd like to do Brooklyn, but that's going to cost me $15,000.
Wow. Do you have that much?
I do. I'm not that broke.
All right.
So I'm going to go ahead and do Brooklyn for $15,000, but I also have to pay...
What are you going to use?
Another $4,000. I'm going to use DC.
All right.
1, 2, 3. I have to give me change for a 20.
What do you need?
I need 20. Give me a 10 of 5 and 5 ones, if you will. Because I have to pay $4,000 to the bank anyway. So just give me 4 ones, and I'll give you 3.
Give you 4 ones? Why are you giving me
3? It just makes the math easier.
Okay. What
do you say to? Okay, so I just paid for that ridiculous expansion in Brooklyn. And I'm going to get 6, 7, 8 ticks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Okay. And...
Alright.
Oh, perfect. Okay. I'm going to use Mr. Stanley.
Actually, I didn't turn somebody over. I'll just turn over.
Okay. Alright, I'm going to use Stanley.
And Stan Lee.
And he's just going to do a technology action and bump this up to level 3.
Mm-hmm.
And I get $6,000 to do that.
Mm-hmm.
So I've got this guy. So I actually get paid to do that, which is pretty cool.
Mm-hmm.
Alright, so you're up.
Turn Lovelace and, well, what can she build? She'll build my works because she has the gear. All right. And that's it.
Okay. And for my last and final move, I'm going to do, all right, so projects are going to cost $3,000 more this turn. And I want to build in Indianapolis.
Mm-hmm.
So let me add this up really quickly. So I'm using Sir Maxim. Normally it would cost me 4. It's now going to cost me 7. right?
Mm-hmm.
Plus, we're in phase three.
Mm-hmm.
So it's going to cost me an additional $3,000
mm-hmm.
to jump through Cincinnati.
Yep.
Right? So 7, 8, 9, 10. So that's going to be 10, but then minus 1.
Yeah.
Because he only pays half the cost. But it's rounded up.
Yep.
So even though it's like 1.5, it's going to be 2. So so that's going to be a $9,000 project. Do you agree?
Mm-hmm.
All right. So let me pay out my 9 first. Oh, and I'm using level 3 technology, so I'm going to have to pay out patents as well.
To both.
So that's going to be
another
6.
It's 15,000. Nice round number.
That's fine. All right, so we'll do that.
And that'll put you in Indianapolis.
That.
So you can power Gen Con.
I can power Gen Con. That's fantastic.
Yes, you can.
I always buy Indianapolis.
You do.
I do.
You like the Colts. I get it. All right, so that's Sir Maxim, right? That's
yep.
the end of his turn.
Mm-hmm.
So let us now go into bookkeeping.
Okay.
So adjust the fame track.
Okay.
So I think
I bumped
to the
top.
So you
are at the top. Yep.
And the player with the highest highest player gets stock gain equal to the phase. So I get a 3-point stock gain.
Okay.
Player with the highest.
Oh, can we stop for a second?
Yeah.
I did not increase my.
Oh, okay.
For building that. And it only goes up 4. But
4 plus 2.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Right. There you go. Okay, sorry.
So, leading technology in DC is going to be Walker again, so
mm-hmm.
she's going to go up 3.
Mm-hmm.
Move AC/DC towards the center.
Okay.
Profits. 24, 22.
Okay.
So, here's a dollar, just give me 25.
Where's our 5?
Yeah, those nice blue ones up there.
Yeah, right. Nice try.
Yeah.
And I'm going to get 22.
All right. So we took profits. Now we can do stock.
Stocks to watch.
Trade a share for another or buy a share.
Okay. Ugh. And this is the last time that we get to buy stocks.
Mm-hmm.
So.
I'm going to buy a share of Maxim.
Yeah?
$32.
You believe in Maxim?
$20.32.
Wow. Okay.
That bumps you up 2, but it gets me a share of Maxim.
Okay.
I hope you do well this round.
I also hope I do well this round. So what am I at? 34.
Mm-hmm.
What do I have going on here? 1, 2, 3. I think I will also buy, my stuff. I think I'm actually going to buy
Walker.
Walker. I know. She's up high.
She really
Walker's
is.
High. It's not time to buy. I have, I already have some Walker anyway. Stop it. I know how the stocks work. Okay. All right. I'm actually going to buy some brush, I think.
Oh.
So you invest in me, I invest in you.
All right.
So that's going to be 38.
Yeah.
Is that right?
That's right.
So, I'm going to switch this out for 250s. You like that math?
Yeah.
All right, so 30.
So you're buying brush.
I'm buying brush.
Yeah,
you know what I should have done here? I'll just get 2 back. That's all I'll do.
I go up 3, right? Because we're around 3.
Mm-hmm.
We are in phase 3.
Yeah. And that was at 38, right?
Did I move you up 2 or 3?
I think you moved me up 2.
I think so, too.
Check the tape.
All right. I'll give you another dollar. So you get a share of brush stock.
I get a share of brush stock. And let me see if I want to do anything else. Oh, and I just did a... I get to receive 3,000 because I did a trade or I purchased stock, right? Or is that after
yeah,
the entire
no, you're right.
thing?
Yeah.
Is that per stock?
You just bought one stock, so
I bought
you get $3,000.
What if I want to buy more stocks?
You can only buy one.
Oh, okay.
So it says, then buy any share of your choice.
2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9, 10. I'm just doing some.
Some bookkeeping?
I don't know how I end up with all these singles. All right.
All right, cool. So that's it. Let's jump into round six. So, flip all the luminaries.
Okay.
Let's do the cleanup. It's the refresh phase. So, luminaries, discard the event, advance the turn track.
All right, last turn.
And that's it. So,
okay. You ready for the event?
I am. Let's reveal
the century.
Oh.
And it is an auction.
Another Saint Nick. Wow.
Why are there so many Saint Nicks?
You may advance any two of your technology markers one space each, but may not file any of the patents. But we're getting a two stock left shift.
Oh, let's okay. So let's do that.
One, two, one, two, one, two, one, two.
Okay. You may advance any two of your technology markers one space each, but may not file any of the patents. All right. So that's what's on the table. It is an auction.
For $6,000.
Do you want that for six?
I'm going to pass. Do you want to pay six for it?
I can move anything one. Oh, I can move any two. One spot.
Any two different ones, one spot. So that would get you to DC four.
Yeah.
That'd be good for you. So
that would be good. Yeah, I think I will do that.
$6,000.
Actually, one, two. Yeah, I'll do that. I'm going to take that.
All right,
so I've got no more money though.
But that's good. So, but you can move them right now because then you're just going to use the event.
All right, yeah, I guess I'll do that. We'll see how that works out.
All right.
And I can move them up. Yep. Boom. Boom.
All right.
Okay.
So let's do their actions and see how they move. That's actually gone now. It's one time.
Yeah. Okay. All right, so Walker?
Yep.
She's going to take... Well, we've got a star.
It would be
so,
this one.
Yeah, go ahead and take
plus
that
two,
one.
So she's going to go up three.
Yep.
So Walker actually takes the lead from
me.
All right.
And then she's going to take the westernmost level four project.
Wow.
So there goes my level four I just bought. Philly, right?
Looks like she's taking Philly. Ooh.
All right.
All right, so she's doing DC. Mm. So that's going to give her an 8-point bump. One,
okay.
2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Jeez.
Wow. And she is going to flip her
lab
and her office.
And her office. Okay.
Okay.
So that was her final action.
And Thompson is going to pick a prop for
right here.
DC one, your last one.
So he's going to go DC two. So he's going to max out DC.
Okay. And then he isn't taking the two northernmost level fours. So.
Ha. Huh. All right. So it looks like he's taking New York.
For me.
New York. And
lovely.
There's nothing
else.
That's so he's going to take a level three. So he'll take Detroit. So Detroit's a mid, New York's a big.
Okay, and he's going to flip his
So he's going to get 6 and 5 is 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. What?
That sucks so bad.
So he's going to 41. Wow.
See, I shouldn't have done that.
Now,
I knew
I
shouldn't have. I listened to you too much.
You don't listen to me.
Works. That's
don't blame
it.
Me.
All right. All right.
Oh.
What are you going to do?
I don't know. This is so terrible.
This is so bad.
I know what I'm going to do first.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to... Oh.
Oh. Well, there's that.
Oh.
1, 2, 3.
Oh. All right, I'm going to take Ada Lovelace, and I'm going to do AC/DC propaganda.
Okay.
So I'm going to get $10,000, and I'm leave the AC/DC track where it is. So
okay.
I just did that for the money.
You did it for the money's the money?
Mm-hmm. I'm all about the money.
Okay. I need to see if I can even afford to do what I want to do right now.
I'm not sure what you want to do.
Oh, you know what I want to do. One, two. So that's going to be 8.
Ooh.
I got to pay patents. How much are my patents going to cost? Patents are going to be 6.
About 6
this
grand
phase.
In patents, yeah.
So that's going to be 6. Yeah, I can't even afford to do that right now. All right. So here's what's going to have to happen. I'm going to use Mr. Faraday.
Mm.
And he is going to have to go spread some dirty propaganda and make me some money.
Which one are you going to do?
And I think I will do... I got to go for all the money. And AC/DC is already up, so I guess I'll get myself up on the track. So
G Wells.
Yeah, and does he have... And he has no dollars. No, he has a propaganda, though, so I get to move this up 3, actually.
Yep.
So I'm going to go 1, 2, 3 and bump him down.
Okay.
Like that. And I get 9.
9 grand, that's it.
9 grand. You know, but I could use her instead.
Get 12 grand.
Right? Yeah, I'd rather do that. Yeah, all right, so that's fine. I'm going to flip her instead and get the 12.
You could do that.
I'm going to do that.
All right, so I'm going to flip Thomas Lawson and use his dollar sign mm-hmm. to build my office.
Okay.
All right.
Okay. And I'm going to... I should be able to afford this now, I think. I'm trying to go after that big project in Newark.
Oh, in Newark?
In Newark, because it's not in Delaware.
Oh.
And it's going to cost me... I've got a project in Worcester.
Right.
So I'm going to have to hop through 1, 2.
1, 2.
I'm going to have to hop through 2 cities.
Yep.
So that's going to cost me a reputation of 6. Yeah.
3.
But it's only going to be 3, because I'm going to use Maxim. So that's going to be 3. Plus the cost of the project is going to be 8.
Yep.
8, 9, 10, 11. Plus the 6... that I have to use for my bulbs, right? So what does that come out to?
17 minus 3 for his dollar.
Minus 3 for his dollar.
$14.
So 14. All right, so that's not so bad.
You can afford it.
I can afford it now that I spread all my propaganda.
You did.
All right, so here's my 14.
All right. And you want to put something
that
in Newark,
and
right?
Could you put that in Newark for me? Yep. And that's going to give me... And I'm using DC, so it's a stock one plus 2 plus 5. So it's going to put me up 7.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Perfect.
Right. Oh, wow. Okay.
He's exhausted.
Right. I'm sure he is. Interesting. Okay. All right. So I will use Charles Brush to build.
Okay.
So he's going to get an additional $1,000 discount per phase when he personally claims a project. So he's going to get 3 grand off.
Nice.
Plus his dollar, which Ooh. Is another 3 grand
nice.
Off.
Nice.
So that's 6 grand off.
It's because he's an entrepreneur. He's a
he's an innovative entrepreneur. So I'm going to build in this Philly mark, right?
Okay.
It's a large city, but it's one city away. So that's a 3,000 cost, but that'll negate. We'll say his entrepreneurial bonus will negate that, right?
Okay.
So I get an additional 3 off of the cost, and the cost is 12. So 3 off of that would be 9.
Okay.
So the project should cost me 9 plus patents. It's a level 3. I own the higher bulb, but I do have to pay her 3 grand because of her DC system.
Mm-hmm.
So I get change for that. So I need 7 grand back.
You pay that to me?
No, to the bank.
Okay. How many do you need? 3?
7.
Sorry, I wasn't paying attention.
I need 7 back so that I can pay for the actual project.
All
now.
Right. There you go.
I need to pay 9 for the project. And I'll just pay you 10 and give me a dollar back.
All right, there you go.
All right, so that costs me a lot, but that's going to give me 8 points. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Mmm.
And that was Brush.
Okay. All right. I'm up.
All right.
I'm going to use William Stanley Jr. And he's going to develop my office. Okay. Or my works, rather.
That's it? Well, you built all of them, huh?
I did. It's Mr. Jordan's boarding house.
All right, so I'll use her megaphone to do my studio. And I immediately set my company fame marker to 1 on the future fame track.
Nice.
So I will take that back from Walker.
Mm. Walker, Texas Ranger.
Yep.
All right, and I'm going to use my last and final card, to do some propaganda.
All right.
End the game with some propaganda. And I'm going to do this one.
Mm-hmm.
So he gets to bump up 3 because he's got 2 plus the 1, mm-hmm. right? So I'm going to go to the top. That. And get $8,000. Just 8.
Just 8.
Just 8. Oops. Okay. Okay.
All right. So that was that. So this is it. Bookkeeping.
Okay.
Adjust the fame track.
Okay.
Highest player gets 3 stock ticks.
Okay.
1, 2, 3.
Okay.
Player with the highest patent gets 3 stock ticks. That's her again.
Mm-hmm.
1, 2, 3. Move ACDC 1 space towards the center. Take profits.
Okay. What are you getting in spoils?
I get 28. Here's 2. I'll take 30. Thank you.
And
you get 24.
Okay.
And stock.
Stock?
Yeah, you go first. Do you want to buy or sell stock?
Well, we I don't think do, we get to do that.
We do them first. Yeah, but there's we do stock, but there's no price shift.
Oh, okay. Got you. So Walker's going to purchase Walker stock.
All right.
And Thompson actually has no stock activity this time.
Very good. Do you want to buy stock?
Yeah, I think I will buy some stocks. Some stocks to watch. What do I have to spend? I can purchase 1. Is that correct?
Yes.
1 stock. What do I want to buy? I think I will invest in Brush.
Okay.
I'm going to buy 1 share of Brush mm-hmm. for 41. Right?
Mm-hmm.
10, 20, 41. Brush, and I get $3,000 for doing that. Okay, you're up.
I'm not going to buy any stock.
Okay.
I literally have just enough to buy your stock, but...
And we're going to bump?
Nope, no bump.
Oh, yeah, no bumps, okay.
No bump. So, that's it. So, that finished the game, and now we basically tally up the scores.
Yeah,
so let's set up the scoring area, and we'll see who was the biggest inventor. Okay, so this is a new scoring system for the game introduced with Powering Up. So we're going to go through and show you how this works, and it's definitely much better than it used to be.
Yes.
Hands down. So we are going to score stock now. So the first thing we do is score points for stock shares. Now, stocks are worth so many points depending on where they where the stock actually
lies
in order of value, right? Mm-hmm. So the highest stock is worth 6 points, then 5 points for the next highest, and then 4 points, 3, 2, 1, etc. So first we'll start with Walker. We'll count the AI stocks up
first. Yes.
So they were accruing stock the whole game. Walker is probably got a mint here. So preferred stock is worth 4 shares. So 4, 5, 6, 7, she's got 8 shares of Walker, right? So 8 shares of Walker, and she's the highest stock, it's worth 6 points, so that's 48 points in just mm-hmm. her stock. She has 3 shares of Maxim, which is actually worth 6, 5, 4, so 12. So 48 and 12 is 60. Mm-hmm. So she has 60 points in stock, so that's her starting score.
Okay.
Now we'll go to Thompson. So Thompson has like everybody's stock, mm-hmm. but we'll start with his. So he's got 4, 5, 6, 7 shares of Thompson, which is worth 5, so it's 35. Plus 6 is 41.
Mm-hmm.
Plus 4 is 45. Plus 5 is 49.
Okay.
So Thompson's got 49 points. We'll go to Maxim.
All right, and I have 6, and then 1, 2, 3, so that's 15.
15 is 21.
Thompson, so 26. They're 5. So, and then my 4 shares of Maxim, so plus 16.
26 plus 16 is 42.
Okay.
All right, so 42 points there. And then Brush does not have as much stock as everybody else. He's got 4. 5 shares of Brush, which is worth 25 points. 25 plus 10 is 35, plus 4 is 39.
Okay.
I went too heavy into Maxim.
Sorry about that.
That was my downfall.
Okay.
But we're close.
Yep.
All right. So that is it for stock. So we've just scored stock. So obviously you can see that stock doesn't always... Mm-hmm. You know, get you the most as far as just instant win. So that was stock shares. Next we do is points for cash. So the highest cash on hand gets 6 points, and then
roll
5
checker. Four.
Yeah, so I've got $37,000 in cash.
Okay, so you get 6 points.
I do, because but it goes for every player now. So you have how much?
Not that much.
Well, no, but we have to compare it to the AI as well.
I have 4.
You have 4,000. So the AI gets as much cash as their profit.
Mm-hmm.
So she's got 30, Walker, mm-hmm. and Thompson's got 28. So I've got 37. So I've got 6, mm-hmm. 5, 4, 3. So I get 6 and you get 3.
You're so excited about that.
No, I'm not.
Yes, you are.
All right. So, points for developing HQ cards. So,
stop for a second.
Yes.
So, you get 6.
Yep.
And they're going to get 5 each?
They're both on the second square?
Yeah.
Yeah, so they both get 5 and you get 4.
Okay, so...
I'm sorry, you don't get 3.
5. I'm trying to take my points. 4. Okay.
And 4. All right, okay. So that's cash.
Mm-hmm.
So now for developed HQ. And this is really okay. Just as if you have them all built. So you and I each get 10 points for having all 4 built.
Okay.
Walker has 3 built, so she gets 6 points.
All right.
And Thompson only has 2 built, so he gets 3 points.
Okay.
All right, and next is... those are points for works. And actually, I think...
And then our HQ cards if we get any victory points.
Yeah, so now HQ victory points. So
yeah, did you want to check the AIs?
Let me check if they have any bonuses. So, yeah, so Walker gets 1 victory point for each city in your largest group of connected cities.
Okay.
So her largest group of connected cities is 2.
Okay.
So she's going to get 1 point for that. She gets 2 points.
Okay.
Thompson gets 2 victory points for each level 4 project he holds. So Thompson's got a level, he's got, let's see, he's got 2,
okay.
So he's going to get 4 victory points.
All right. And what about you?
I get 5 victory points if I hold at least 1 level 1, 2, 3, and 4 projects.
Okay. And do you?
I have a level 4, 1.
Those are not yours.
Oh, sorry. 2, 4, 3, and 1. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yep.
Okay,
so I get
cool.
5.
So you get 5. It's Brush.
That's Brush.
Okay.
And you?
And then I get 1 VP for each group of cities unconnected to another group of cities. So I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
6 points. All right. So
okay.
Let's add them up and see where we end up. Okay.
All right.
as expected, Walker steamrolled us.
Uh-huh.
And I think it's because we let her stock get so high.
We should have started selling her stock, I think, and we didn't really employ that strategy at all.
Yeah, she steamrolled us from the start.
Yeah.
AI was tough. Her AI is so tough. So
yeah.
At least we beat Thompson.
We did. That's good.
Very close game, though.
Very close game.
Yeah.
Very balanced. And I like how even the AIs really are balanced right with us.
Yeah, and
which
they
says
all,
a lot.
They seem to play, we've done this a few times now, and they seem to play very thematically. So I will
they
save
do.
That
yeah,
for the final.
Exactly.
But so that's Thompson, Tesla versus Edison, or Thompson versus Walker,
really.
Brush versus Maxim, however you want to say it. But
yeah.
This is the powering up expansion. Let's go talk about it, and we'll recap. Okay, Tesla versus Edison powering up.
What do you think?
I think it's terrible. No, I'm just kidding. I think, hands down, this is probably one of the best game-changing expansions that I've played for any game.
Absolutely.
Yeah, I mean, it took a game that was kind of predictable and wasn't so much about building up your business and your empire and spreading across the map, and more about How much stock can I buy and sell and manipulate the stock market at the end of the game in the final round just to get the win, right? I mean, that's what it came down to, where you know, all of that's gone. And before it was like, okay, I can do three different things, boom, 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 rinse and repeat. And then, I mean, that's pretty much it. Where this one now, you know, sets the events, so the stock market's all over the place. There's no more just free buying and selling stock. They've really clamped that down, and at the end they've changed the scoring system. So fantastic. Yep. So
and the context is great. The research that was done for this game was fantastic. I'm kind of a nerd about that stuff, so I like that the you know characters thematically their actions kind of back up what they did historically as well, so that's kind of cool, and the flavor and everything is kind of neat.
And the AI decks for what you get for value, for how long it takes, you know, how much time it adds to the game is ridiculous, because you're talking about 2 to 3 minutes of doing moves for them probably across the entire game,
and not to completely
change and mix up the way the game plays itself, just by the way they manipulate their stocks. They're taking patents. They're doing all sorts of things, and you've got to try to keep up. And you said like Walker, just like right out of the gate, boom, just started ripping up stocks, researching everything, and you know, and just left us in the dust. And we just the whole time we weren't playing defensively. I think that's why she ran away with it at the end.
But we did put it on kind of expert. So with the AI decks that you have. You have the option of playing, first of all, you have the option of playing as all six different inventors folks,
and they're double-sided. Each inventor is double-sided, and the game, the expansion itself, comes with six inventors,
right?
Double-sided, so it's 12 different AIs. And then at Gen Con, we picked up the bonus expansion, which I think might have been a Kickstarter add-on, but we were able to get that as well. So now we've got like 24 different AIs that we can choose from, you know, four for each inventor. So you can even mix that up. Because last night we played with Tesla and Edison as the AI, and it was a completely different game. You know,
completely
it was
like different experience.
Edison branching out from Menlo Park and pushing DC the whole game. And Tesla was trying to push AC. So you saw them battling back and forth while we're just kind of going for the ride.
So replayability is great. The scoring is really cool at the end. It's very balanced. Again, we usually come out, you know, pretty close, even though our strategy is different.
I'd say with the addition, like before, if I were to give scores,
okay.
I don't want to get in the habit of giving scores, but I think just for the sake of argument, if I were to give scores, like before the expansion, we played it, we enjoyed it.
Yes,
it wasn't great. I loved the theme. I loved the mechanics until we got to the stock market bit. Just getting at the end of the game, I was just like, it lost me at that point. So I would have probably given it like a 6.5 out of 10, maybe a 7. You know, just because of that, I mean, it was such a big downer, that whole stock piece.
Yeah.
But with this expansion, this one is in the upper nines for me.
Oh, yeah.
It is in my absolute, especially now that it's solitaire driven with AI, and I love the way people do AIs, but this is definitely in my top 10.
Yeah, for sure.
Absolute top 10 best. I think, I would say in my, for solitaire, sure, but I think it plays even better with a few players plus AI.
We're actually really excited to get together like some friends and then also include the AIs.
Yeah, to do like a three human, two AI, three human, three AI, whatever you want to do. It's like, it's so variable. It's awesome. So there it is, Tesla vs. Edison, powering up expansion. Highly recommended.
Okay.
So thanks for watching. Please subscribe, leave comments, point out any rules, mistakes. I'm sure there's a few slip ups here and there, but I don't think much. We kind of
did
okay
that
time.
Good job.
So thanks. We'll see you next time.
Okay. See ya.